After an hour or so chatting with Trinny Woodall, virtually, of course, I'm amazed she didn't start a beauty business earlier. Not only because her brand, Trinny London, is one of Europe's fastest-growing direct-to-consumer startups, with a £180 million $250 million valuation, but that she talks about the industry with more passion than anyone I've ever interviewed. Best known as the taller half of international style duo Trinny and Susannah, Woodall spent much of her 30s jet-setting, introducing super-slimming style makeovers to Oprah's viewers and co-hosting TV shows that taught women how to dress. The most iconic of which being What Not to Wear, which celebrates its 20th anniversary this year. The breakout BBC show, which spawned from their newspaper column of the same name, took fashion-challenged individuals, secretly nominated by friends and family, through a gruelling makeover process led by Trinny and Susannah's teetering-on-offensive style critiques, and the world couldn't get enough. Tag line, we'll tell you what your best friend won't. It was very rule-driven, and I've always found rules helpful in my life, but the language, of how I talk to women, has changed so much, she tells me from her walk-in wardrobe over Zoom. The language I use now is much closer to my heart, not, you can't wear a polo neck if you have big tits, you know, she brushes a few tong-ed curls back as she rolls her eyes. I made over many women in What Not to Wear, and then in consequential shows that I did across Europe, when we were no longer Flavour of the Month in the UK. I did 3 years of going to about 16 countries, and it really cemented, for me, the sense that it doesn't matter your religion, the color of your skin, where you live, the emotive feelings that people have are the same. She began thinking through the concepts for Trinny London years before its 2017 launch, always that thing of an entrepreneur, when do you get it out of your head and onto the kitchen table, knowing her own relationship with the beauty industry presented problems that women needed answers to. Whenever I've made over a woman, or she's been on one of our shows, the first thing she notices is her makeup, she says. A makeover for a woman is not the clothing. It's everything together. It's her hair, her makeup, her new skincare routine, sometimes her clothing, how she perceives herself as a result of all those things coming together. Depending on how a woman feels about her body, she might notice hair and makeup more. It's the most transformative thing. I had many, many years of acne, so I was always obsessed with makeup. I wore way too much, too orange, horrible pink lips, every single mistake in the book. I was quite obsessed with the women who weren't hiding themselves behind it. Woodall started taking cocaine as a teenager, hoping it would give her the confidence her battle with chronic acne had stolen.